I hope everybody's having a wonderful Sunday evening movie, but I wanted to jump on and just see how everybody's doing on Sunday night. So what did you guys do today? There's a lot of people out there right now that just don't even feel like working, right? So you're out there, you're on the grind, you're doing what you need to do. And that's commendable. Just waiting for certain couple people to come in. I get frustrated with all of that. I really am, especially the latest video. I don't know if you've seen it. Have you seen the latest video where she basically tries to blame the landlord for her daughter's cheer team losing? Or whatever, I don't even know, tries to make it about them. No, never takes accountability, briefly. But I will say this much. In regards to the video that she posted, guys. But into that, first of all, losing, when we lose, that is a part of life. It is a necessary part of life. It helps build our character. It allows for us to grow as individuals. How I see it is that she basically, if she had her daughter thinking that she was going to, this was in the bag, they had it, they were gonna get that jacket, they were gonna get that medal, then yeah, she set her up to fail. Because as a parent, you of course encourage your child to win, but you also prepare them for the fail. But she's a narcissist, so she doesn't know exactly. And, you know, I find the main issue I have at this point is, of course she's scamming people. Of course, you know, she's lying to people, and her whole excuse is, well, if they don't want to donate, they don't have to. Well, that would be one thing if you're telling the truth. But you're not telling the truth. You're manipulating people. You're not being honest with people with how much money you've received already. I mean, let's be honest. Between all of the GoFundMes over the years, all of the Cash App and the Venmo and the her having a Christmas covered and having her her hotel paid for the past 6 months, she has had more donations and, you know, she has had more charity than some charities at this point. And my main issue at this point is the entitlement, the tone deafness of it all, the just, you know, there are people that lost everything that they own that's no fault of their own. You're looking at people that are, people that had fires, their house burned down, hurricane victims, tornado victims, earthquake victims. Look what happened over in Turkey and Syria. Look what Ukraine is going through. You know, there are people that just had to leave their homes, leave everything behind, and they don't know if their home's even still standing because it probably got bombed. Hi, hot single dad. More donations than Red Cross. I don't know about Red Cross, but I'm telling you what. She could have paid to have her stuff. That's the thing. That's the thing. All that was required for her to get all of her daughters and her things back, her multi-generational things, right? All they had to do, all the landlord was asking was pay the fees that it cost me to move these things out of my home that you squatted in, and to, you know, to store these all the time that I had to store your belongings in storage, which was $10,000. She received over, what was it, $16,300 and something. I knew it was roughly right around there. Straight cash in her hand. She could have easily went and paid all that stuff, off, got all of her belongings. She'd had enough left over to go and get herself an apartment, a little apartment or a little house. And all she would have had to do at that point was get a job. And she would have been right as rain. But she didn't do that. She would rather keep her money to spend on herself. And you're right that we should have the right to defend ourselves on our own. Yes. Yeah.
Are you eating this?
That's another thing that I said in my statement is that it's not right. It is not right. I know she would go and make these horrible accusations. And then, you know, first of all, what she did was she unblocked everyone because she had us blocked from way back in October when she created the account. She unblocked everyone. Then she doxed everyone and made all these false narratives and false accusations about them. And then when we went to try to the live to try to defend ourselves, she hurries up and blocks us or mutes us so that we couldn't defend ourselves. Galicia. Yeah, she has a whole list of people that she has bullied, harassed, doxxed, all in her goal of sad fishing, I guess. It's scary. And I don't know, I am filling out, it's taken me a while because there's so much to write because I literally put the whole story in there because the whole story needs to be documented. And I'm adding people like Bernie. I'm adding the person who I think her name is American. I don't know. A lot of people said that there was a bunch of stuff going on. I missed it going on Reddit, and that's how people came to think it was me. So I'm adding that person into my statement. I want them all in trouble. You're encouraging someone who you know is lying. Like you can't say, oh, well, I didn't really think she was lying because the evidence is out there. It's out there. And it doesn't matter if there's more to the story. It doesn't. Because what matters is that what she said thus far, the evidence that's out there, it's damning enough. You know, like your whole story originally was based on the fact that the grandmother supposedly kidnapped your daughter. And we all come to find out you got defamation for that. So that alone right there. And my minor children are still on her page. That's okay. Every day that it sits up there, we'll be we'll be legal trouble for her. Why a new subreddit was created called court_sanction_lies. Oh, there's a new Reddit. That is awesome. Honestly, I don't know if people will feel offended by that, but I think in my mind, honestly, is the more exposure, the better, you know, just like the more accounts that people have out there, the better. One be just for the snarking, and the other be for just people who just want to see the documentation. Because sometimes, I guess maybe the snarking can, you know, get in the way maybe of the... I think both pages are probably going to be amazing though. It makes me disgusted when I know there's so many people out there struggling because of inflation. There are people out there that are busting their butts. They're really trying to handle things themselves and they need help. They're the ones that should be getting all these donations. Having a charity pay for you to live in a hotel for 6 months whenever you, allegedly for 6 months, whenever you, you had gotten over $16,000 in donations, that is a waste of resources. But I do, I want to press charges against her, because you cannot just go and, you know, put my picture out there, put my children's names and locations out there, and think that that's okay. Especially, and then make all these false narratives about me, like, you really did get the wrong person, and not that it matters, because even if I were that person, which I'm not, but I'm just saying, like, even if I were these people or these accounts or whatever, like, they're not doing anything wrong either. Because I know I'm not going to get a lot of people in my life because they've been reporting my accounts, or at some point they reported all of my videos. Even, like, all of my videos. Just simple ones of me, like, showing flowers off. They reported them. Didn't work. But the point is, it got me shadow banned. My children are still being doxxed. Their location. And the person's still scamming people out of tons of money. So I'm gonna keep standing up for justice. Standing up for other people so they don't get scammed. That's not okay. And they still have their hand out for more help, yet refuse to help themselves to get a job or even try to get a job because, you know, they have too much litigation going on in their life to worry about working. Do you know how many mothers and fathers have to deal with custody battles? How many victims of a crime out there have to go and worry about testifying while also healing and trying to live their life and work? Like, that's the most pathetic excuse I've ever heard in my life. So yeah, I am going to continue to scream to the rooftops. And the sad part about it all this is I had moved on. I had moved on. That's so funny that you would say that, because I had given my opinion, and I've moved on with my life, and that's silly. I think everybody's goal is just to get the information out there, from what I've seen anyway. Shock over the latest video. I truly am completely in shock over it. I just, to sit there and blame the landlord. First of all, I don't know about any of you, but as a parent, if my child lost something of importance, of that much value to them, what is the first thing that we're gonna do? We are going to jump to see if we can get it replaced, right? So how did this not even become a thought in her head? You know, I think it, just like the Goodwill items that she was like, threw a big fit over. Oh, these are our multi-generational things. And then she never ended up going to even get them, to even retrieve them. You know why? Because I don't think it's so much about the things being lost in itself as it is the things being lost serving as an opportunity for her to further slander, harass, and attack this innocent landlord for sympathy. Oh, thank you, Erin. Thank you very much. But yeah, I think that is, I think that's all this stuff is to her. It's her opportunity to be able to play the victim. But she's not the victim when you had, and I keep repeating this, and I'm so sorry, Erin. I know I keep repeating this, but you had $16,000 in your hand. $10,000 is all it would have took to get all of your items back. $6,000 left over. You chose to stay in the hotel and blow the money. So I don't know what to say. Ooh, good news. What? A new document that I see on the new subreddit shows that she's liable. Oh, that would be great. Oh, I think I heard something about that. Oh my goodness, I saw this on one of the accounts. Oh, maybe I'm wrong. Is it something like she has to show up somewhere? If she doesn't show up, then yeah, you're saying she'll be arrested. Boy, wouldn't that be nice to actually see justice work? I think the charity needs to be questioned because I heard that not only have they paid for her to live in this hotel for like the last 6 months, but even before the hotel, that they had given her money for housing prior. So, I don't know. Like I said, this woman has received more charity than some charities. Any poor soul who actually rents her a house or an apartment, I feel so sad for. She's a squatter. I just don't know. They have her documented as a sovereign citizen. And sovereign citizens, they know how to use every loophole within our legal system. Sovereign citizens don't hold themselves to the same laws that we do. Get the information out there because, you know, you really want to. This, I feel this is like actually Dateline worthy. I really do. I feel like this is going to be on Dateline one day. I really think people should be reaching out to Dateline and they should be giving them all this information because it's crazy. Really think that Dateline needs to take this story. They need to investigate it because it has all of the aspects that need addressed, like, you know, the hot topics. Not only do you have the TikTok topic where there's so much heat already on TikTok, but this is like a pretty, you know, where there's children being doxxed and the squatting, I mean, it just, you go, the daughter, just all of it. I mean, there's so many aspects to this story that would catch fire if it would just reach the right audience. It hasn't even really become viral on TikTok yet. It thinks that she's gotten heat now. Like, she doesn't even understand the level of heat she would get if this would actually be noticed by some of the larger creators. Oh, it would be like, and that's the whole point. We need to get this to go viral again. We need to get this out there again because people need to see this. Like, I can't believe it. Every day that I get on here and I see all this stuff and my head is just like, my mind is blown. And she's just living on someone else. I mean, and the stuff, guys, the stuff on her wish list. There are moms and dads, like the stuff that she even picked out for her daughter, like there are moms and dads working hard that can't even afford that kind of furniture for their kids. Yeah, she's expecting other people to buy this furniture for her child. She wants to live in luxury on someone else's dollar without working at all for it, without earning it whatsoever. This is what really gets me mad. Bernie, if you're watching, or if any of you guys are watching, get on a live with me. Let's talk. Come on, let's talk. Are you in here? Come on, let's talk. Because I don't understand how you don't understand, because you do understand. And it makes me so angry, your whole excuse of, oh, well, if you don't want to support, simply don't support. It is so much more in depth than that, and you know that. It would be one thing if her story was legit, but when the things coming out of her mouth, there is actual evidence out there that says that's not true, and she's not being forthcoming with that. Like, she's lying. Like, you're basically lying to people. Yeah, Burn drives me absolutely crazy. you're basically lying to people. It's like, it would be like me going, Christ, I lost everything. I lost my home. I lost everything while I'm still sitting in my home. And then, you know, people feeling bad and donating to me, and then me going, I didn't get no, like, me not being honest with people, not telling anybody, like, that all these people gave me money, but still sitting there whining about how I'm broke. That's how this, oh, it drives me nuts. Yeah. I posted a couple videos about it, and I was like, you know what? I moved on. And this is why. It's because I felt like she was very mentally unstable. There was a child involved, and I just didn't want to, I just wanted to move on. Because I just thought, this woman really needs some mental help. But then when she decided to attack me out of nowhere, that was a whole different story. And that's just the thing, is like, Bernie's sitting there blocking and muting and blocking and muting and block. I mean, she's just not even allowing, like, nobody's allowed to go and be like, well, why do you have someone doxed? Why do you have two children doxed on your profile? You sit here and you talk about how dangerous it is to expose your child's location, even though you expose your child's location every cheer competition. You've exposed your child's location in all of your court documents that you show, that show nothing but your location and, like, everybody else's, the enemies you're against, their location. Like, you can't even ask her those things. Like, you know, immediately muted. Or, did you see the, I saw somebody wrote her the other night, did you see the court documents? Or, guys, have you not read the court documents? Immediately gone. And then she goes, all these accusations. And then somebody asked her, what do you think people are accusing you of? Or, you claim that all these people did this to you or did that to you. What is it do you think that they did to you? Give examples. Immediately she got an attitude and took that away. So it's frustrating because, like, they sit there and they're acting like, well, we're just deleting the hate. No, you're not. You're deleting any, you're not getting hate. That's the funny part about it. You're not even getting hate. You're getting people coming to your page trying to ask you or trying to confront you with the truth. That's what you're getting. There's a huge difference. You know, when we find out it's not true, we're trying to hold you accountable. Don't sit here and try to twist it to be something else it's not. Because it's just wrong. It's just wrong. And you're putting children, not only yours, but now mine and whoever else's that you may dox or have doxed in the past. Like, you have put them in danger. Like, oh, please get on the live with me. Like, I beg them. And if anybody's recording this, let's edit it down and let's send it to them, because I'm done. Her controlling the narrative, her preventing anybody from being able to, you know, her claiming that when someone is she's not receiving hate. It's basically just people trying to confront her with the truth, and she's calling that hate, and it's really kind of ticking me off. But yeah, I'm putting Bernie is officially, I'm about ready to press charges on her, because she's encouraging this. She is encouraging my two children to continue to be doxxed. She is encouraging, every time this woman gets on it, on her thing, and she sits there and says, all these haters, all these accounts, these people, this person that doxxed me, this, that, she's essentially insinuating me, because she already done told her whole mass of people that I'm main ringleader. Like, I have the recording of her telling people that I'm this main ringleader, and I'm not. And yep, that's the other one. That is the other one that I am personally going after. And if you're recording this, send that to her too, because I'm going after her too. That is absolutely ridiculous that someone reached out to me and they told me, look, I hate to tell you this, but they were insistent on saying that you are this person and you are that person, and I'm like, what? Like, I don't even know any of these people. Like, what? And yeah, so that's the person that actually started it all. They went and they told Tara that I'm guilty of this and I'm guilty of that. That's one thing. That's one issue. But then for her to be stupid enough to just listen to some random TikToker and believe what they say and act on it, that makes her guilty. And then you have Bernie and Beth. Random thoughts on Reddit. Yeah, I hear that she's now going by something Keller glasses off, I think now. That's what I heard. I'm documenting all of this, so believe you me, because I can have, yes, rose-colored glasses off. Yeah, I have it all documented, along with the videos that they've posted and all of it. Like, they don't understand. you know, IP addresses can be tracked. And when they are tracked, like, they're gonna see that I'm innocent, and that's not gonna be a good look for them. They're gonna fall, and they're gonna fall hard. There was a couple people actually trying to accuse all of the Reddit people of just being like a bunch of old bitter women. And it's like, if you guys are that gullible and that stupid, have at it, you know? That's how I feel at this point. For anybody that actually wants to continue to support her, the only ones I feel bad are the ones that they only got bits and pieces of the story, so they don't know. I actually thought about doing a video where I challenge both Tara. I challenge all three of them. Let's get on a live. Let's discuss your accusations. I also heard they tried to claim that I never adopted, I never fostered. I have evidence of all of that. Continue to report these videos. The videos, a lot of her videos on her account are clear and direct violation of the guidelines. I know the one doxing all the individuals, including myself and my children, that one is a clear and direct violation of guidelines, and it should be known. Oh, they'll never get on with me because I represent truth. I see a lot of new information circulating about the TikTok advocate. I personally am very angry with the TikTok advocate. I feel that she needs to have, and I do feel bad that she was threatened by this woman and her family was made to feel unsafe. But at the same time, had you simply, like, I was there, okay? I know how it unfolded, and I can tell you this much. She didn't research it. She just took whatever documents that this woman sent her, the Tara sent her. She took the documents. She briefly looked over them. She called that good enough. And then she promoted this mother's story. Within, I'd say, 24 hours, this mother had over 500,000 followers. And she had over $17,000 in GoFundMe money. People the whole time were trying to warn her. I mean, they were flocking her page. You don't know the whole story. Did you actually look at the actual court records? Like, I know that she's providing you documentation, but that's not the whole story. I'm not saying, no one's saying dad's perfect, but she's certainly not giving the whole story. She has guilt too. And, the TikTok advocate was quite rude. I'm sorry, but she was. She kept deleting and blocking people. She wouldn't have it. She wouldn't listen. She didn't care. She ended up doing a video on Kathleen, like, oh, she's trying to tell me I should do my due diligence. Guess what? I did do my due diligence there, Kathleen. And then Kathleen ended up getting all of these death threats. Her children got death threats because, you know, the TikTok advocate has over 1 million followers. And then when it started to come out that she was lying, and the thing, you know, the TikTok advocate finally saw, was saying, like, she she created all of this, and then when she found out the truth, what she ended up doing, she did a recant video for Kathleen, but that wasn't good enough. Like, you know, that you tormented that girl, and you knew exactly what you were doing by doing that video. It was a little snarky video you did, and I'm sure it's somewhere out there. But anyway, she found out, she did the recant video, and then within minutes, she tears down the recant video because she gets scared, because she gets threatened or whatever, and she does this video where she's just like, okay, well, you know, da-da-da-da-da, I'm glad that she has a home, but we just need to move on. From here on forward, I'm going to make sure I just research things better. And then, after that, in a live, of course, you guys see those videos where she admits that she was scared, and that's why she didn't leave the recant video up, and that she just didn't want to talk about her. But, like, you created this mess, and now as a result, you got this woman, you created a monster, and now she has no right to even call herself an advocate at this point, because an advocate would have never backed down. I rescue cats, and I have a couple that are getting ready to, they're scheduled to go in and get fixed, but before I could get them in to go get fixed, they are in heat. They're all females, so, but they're in heat, and now they're acting so stupid right now. Sorry, Bori. Oh, I know. Go ahead. She had been asking the last couple days, and I just wanted to give her some support. Because, like I said, I know how scary it is. I didn't mean to get into this whole rant. Honestly, this woman's not worth the energy. And my message of the day is compassion is the constant act of giving oneself to others.
Yeah.
All right, guys. So I'm going to jump off here, but I hope you all have a wonderful Sunday.